People often ask me, where is Ogunquit Maine? What is it like? Actually, Ogunquit's only about 80 miles from Canada. Maine, the way life should be. Actually, Ogunquit is an Indian word for a beautiful place by the sea. It's the kind of place that Norman Rockwell has painted many times. It's the kind of place where Martha Stewart and Barbara Walters lives. It's the kind of place where they think taking a trolley is the only way to go. Can anybody tell me why people are staring at me? I mean, I do fit in, right? Well, anyway, let's go on with the tour. Now, this pathway is actually called Marginal Way. It runs all along Ogunquit Beach, where you'll see some of the most expensive homes and the most beautiful exclusive hotels. They also have some of the most beautiful and clean beaches you'll ever see. Our first stop, Perkins Cove. You guys are gonna love this place. And if you guys are looking for restaurants with a view, there's plenty of them. But maybe you're not hungry. Maybe you just want a coffee and a cupcake. Well, Breaking New Ground is definitely a place to go. And I'd like to dedicate this red velvet cake to my sister, the Queen of Red Velvets. Did I mention it also had an amazing view? And if you're not hungry, you can go up this bridge and get a beautiful view of the whole town. Come on, I'll show you guys around. Perkins Cove have some great places to shop at, with all types of antique shops, specialty shops, clothing stores, candles. It really is a fun place to go. But of course, this is why I came, for the Footbridge Lobster at Perkins Cove. It's a perfect little spot just to grab a bite and go. Now I have to tell you, the lobster bisque is really for the amateurs, because it's a light creamy base with a little baby piece of lobster. But see, lobster stew was for the real seafood eater, because there's big chunks of lobster claw and lobster tail in a butter and cream based soup. This is the real thing, guys. I have to say I consider myself a very safe eater, but today I'm feeling a little risky. I think I'm going to go for the swordfish sandwich with the potato salad. Now I have to say the presentation was great. The toasted bun, the potato salad. Now the chef actually told me that this was grilled with 7 different spices, like Cajun, salt, pepper, lemon and lime, and also comes with lettuce and a spicy tartar sauce. And what's so great about it, because they actually toast both sides of the buns with butter. Now, even though I've been eating seafood my whole life, I actually never tried swordfish sandwiches. But I have to say, after eating this one, it's definitely a great sandwich. Now, the locals keep telling me, make sure you have the grilled cheese. So I keep wondering, why would I have a grilled cheese at a lobster house? Oh, I see why. Because they have a grilled cheese stuffed with real lobster. And here it is, guys. Yes, big chunks of fresh Maine lobster. So light and sweet. Smothered with aged cheddar cheese, and they grill it on their homemade white bread, which is toasty, warm, and crunchy. Okay, guys, DoTube aside, show aside, jokes aside, this is the greatest thing I truly ever ate. If anyone asked me the best thing I ever ate on my shows, this would have to be the best thing I've ever eaten. Unbelievable.
So I guess the chef kind of figured out I was a big eater, because he told me that the tuna burgers were fresh today. Now, this is not the tuna fish you get out of the can. This is actual tuna from the sea. Now, please don't be too quick to judge, because I have to say that this tuna ground up like a hamburger grilled to perfection on a toasted bun and lettuce was pretty good. Now, you might be asking yourself, what is that green substance? Well, if you're a sushi eater, you would already know that this is wasabi mayonnaise. I told you you shouldn't judge a book by its cover. Now, of course, you would think after all that food, it'd be time to go. And that's what I thought, until I seen this sign. Your eyes did not deceive you. Lobster on a stick. Oh God, help me. And here it is, guys. It's a lobster tail cut in two with two claws on a stick. Absolutely delicious.
Now I know I said this is the type of place to just come in, eat something and go. But you see, when you get lobster on a stick, shish kebab style, you gotta come back for more. Oh God, fantastic.
I guess you guys know when you eat at a restaurant often enough, you get to know the chef, who's a pretty cool guy. And relax, that's a root beer in my hand. Okay guys, now I'm gonna show you what downtown Ogunquit looks like. Now you definitely don't want to miss Bread and Roses Bakery Shop, with their beautiful outside where you can sit and watch the view. But if you want the food, you're going to have to go inside. And you can't miss Ogunquit's oldest candy shop, Harbor Candy Shop. If you can imagine it, they got it. And I know why the gypsy crossed the road, to get to Rose Coast Cafe. It's probably the prettiest area in Ogunquit, because of the beautiful lights and the perfect view of the whole town. Now you don't want to sit outside too long, because inside they have a fixin' bar where you can create your own sundae. Well, since I haven't ate in about an hour, it's definitely time for dinner. And since I ate enough seafood to last me a week, I feel like Italian. And Cafe Prego is the perfect place to go. The owner actually went to Florence, Italy to decorate his restaurant. You guys gotta see this place.
My love has told me, when it stops, we must part. Play some music for broken dreams, for my dreams have shattered, the pieces scattered, just like my heart.
Now, of course, we started off with an Italian antipasto, with green olives, asparagus, arugula, real pepperoni, and smoked prosciutto. And of course the soup had to be Italian wedding, with miniature meatballs and spinach in a chicken broth. They also give you a slice of Italian toasted bread. We also went for the brick oven pizza, which was covered with fresh mozzarella, roasted red peppers, and big chunks of artichoke hearts. And what would Italian feast be without spaghetti and meatballs? These spaghettis were thick, rich, and definitely can satisfy a big fat guy like me. I have to say these meatballs are pretty good.
Basta un poco di musica, basta la melodia.
Now they have all different kind of flavors of gelato. But I got something special for you guys. First they take a croissant and cut it in half.
Play some music for broken hearts. Play it softly and
then you get to pick two gelato flavors to stuff it with. I went for tiramisu and chocolate chip. Can I get one more dip, please? Thanks. Then it's covered with real Italian whipped cream. And to top it off, warm caramel dressing. This was absolutely delicious.
Play some music for broken hearts.
Our friends often ask us, aren't you guys bored out there? But with all this great food, great shopping, and amazing atmosphere, would you? Well, I hope you guys enjoyed my tour of Ogunquit, Maine. Until next week, God bless.
I'm too serious. Bobby, it's not that dining. See you later.
Okay, I know I keep saying that this was the type of place you stop in for a minute and grab something to eat and go, but when you're a fat guy like me, you gotta stop and eat the food because it is unbelievable. Okay, I know I told you guys this type of place you would just stop, grab something to eat, and go. But see, when you got food like this, great food, you want to keep coming back over and over and over.
Why don't you say,
hey, this is lobster shish kebab. Shish kebab lobster.
Now, I know I said this type of place you come in once, eat something, and go. But you see, when you got lobster shish kebab, you gotta come back and try it. Especially when you're a fat guy like me.
Did I get
no by accident?
So you
need a knife?
Nope.
Oh. Nah, just unbelievable.
Oh. I think I did it all. Okay.